Hi, my name is Dirk-Jan Uitermogenhaard and I'm a Technical Solutions Architect at Cisco. And today I received a Webex Room Bar and I would like to show you how this can be deployed. So note that the only thing that I prepared is of the cables. I took these little plastic metal thingies off the cable because that's just annoying and I don't want to bother you with that. So let's see how this is going to work. This is the package and it contains a room bar, power cable, which I don't need, I have plenty, a power supply, great, and besides the room bar, let me see, this is a very nice paper packaging. Besides the room bar, we also have paper, so we don't like those. Here is a network cable, HDMI cable. Here's some plastic thingies. This is a very nice, very thin cable that I believe can be used with the Webex Navigator. And some cleaning stuff. And these must be the screws that can be used to mount the room bar on a screen. And obviously this is the Webex Navigator together with a stand. Let's unpack the room bar. It's a very nice and compact device with a number of connections. Webex Navigator, network, USB ports, HDMI ports, power connection. And on the front side, there is the speakers, microphone array, and a camera. This, by the way, is part of the mounting bracket, so that I won't be using. But I will connect the power to the device. And I guess a network cable would be great. So that's a network cable. And when you look at the Navigator, you can see it has an Ethernet powered port, so I can use I can even connect this to a regular power over Ethernet switch, but in this case I'm going to connect it to the device. And before you plug the cable in, make the cable go through the footstand. I have a nice and small cable which is great for testing, so I'm going to put this on the back of the Navigator. And then let me see what is the top. I should be able to snap this in. Now I have a very nice setup and this goes into the Webex room bar. So mounting the room bar on the screen that I have is not possible because I already have a mounting bracket on the backside and I don't feel like I'm taking that off. But right now the room bar lies on its back, so camera facing up, which is not ideal. So last weekend I was searching the internet and I found the 3D designs for a mounting bracket for the Webex room bar right here. So I printed those and now I'm going to see if they actually fit. Here's the room bar and these brackets should clip on like that. And by the way, nice detail is the logo that is part of the bracket at the bottom side. By the way, I'm going to put the link to this 3D model in the description below, so feel free to take a look. And look at that. That is fantastic. Next, I'm going to turn on the Webex room bar and I'm going to configure it. I received a 16-digit code that allows me to instantly register the device. And after that, I'm going to apply configuration to the device. But I'll show you how that works, because I can configure the device like within 10 seconds. Turn on the room bar. There's a little switch between the HDMI cable and the power port. And you'll see the LED starting to blink and the logo appears on the Navigator. And I'm going to do something that I just love to do. So satisfying. There it is. Welcome. I'm going to click start. It has an IP address. I want it to connect to the Webex cloud. And I'm going to enter the 16-digit code that is typically given to you by some administrator. And this should now activate the device. And by the way, this code can be used only once, and now it has been used. But feel free to try. It will confirm that the system has been activated. Yes, that's a sound check that you can't skip, but it helps the device to learn about the environment. So the setup has been completed, and I should now see the regular screen. Yes, there it is. Hi. So now we're going to configure the device, and as you can see by the time, there's actually quite some time between me going through the configuration process and doing this, and that basically happened because with the first recording of this, I forgot to enable the audio. So there was just video of me talking, but you couldn't hear what I was saying. Rookie mistake. I mean, this is one of the first videos that I'm recording, so that can happen. So right now I'm gonna run a Python script that will push configuration to the device. Let's see what it does. It will first get the device ID. It will then add a user. It will set all kinds of configuration items, and it will add user interface. It will add a macro, and it will enable the macro. And that is cool. And as you can see right there, one of the configuration changes that was made is the self view mode, which is upper center and on. And that basically is why this thing appeared. So let's take a look at the device itself, see what macro and what user interface it added. We're going to take a look at the device, and one big change that you can see right now is that it has an extra button, and that is part of the user interface that I added, and a macro that sits behind it. And the macro controls two lamps that are on the left and right side of the device, which are Philips Hue play bars. So let's take a quick look, and the user interface gives me the option to change the color, to turn them on or off. So actually this is off, on. But I can also change the brightness, and let's switch to cool white. And how can we, what's the best way to see that? Cool white, I can switch to red, which can be used if you want to show people that you're in a call, or green in case you are available. But we're going to go back to the normal warm white mode. Something else I added is a little button that allows you, that allows the user interface to pull the information, like temperature information and humidity, from this particular device, from the navigator, and it displays it on the screen. This is data that you can also use in other environments, building management, etc. More on that in other and upcoming videos. So how was this setup for me? First of all, it was easy. Oh, unpacking was good. Everything is right there. There was not a second where I had to think about or look at the documentation. I already had the code that allows me to register the device to the Webex cloud, and I created a piece of code that does a lot of the provisioning. And there's multiple tools to do that. You can do things through Control Hub. You can do things with other tools like CE Deploy. By the way, all the links are in the description. And if you're interested in this particular piece of code, this Python script that I created, leave a comment or reach out to me on Webex, and I would be glad to share that with you. So for now, I hope it was useful, and if you have any other ideas on videos that help you, that make sense, let me know. Bye.